Sokka, my only brother. We constantly roam these icy South Pole seas, and yet never do we find anything fulfilling.
All I want is a full feeling in my stomach. I'm starving.
Lemur!
Dinner.
Don't listen to him. You're gonna be my new pet.
Not if I get him first.
Wait, come back!
I wanna eat you!
Now comes the bad news. No food allowed in the canyon. It attracts dangerous predators.
No food? This is ridiculous!
Aw, you babies can go a day without food. Would you rather be hungry or dead? Now we're heading down in 10 minutes. All food better be in your gut or in the garbage.
Blow on it. It's too hot for her.
Allow me.
Oh, my.
Avatar Aang, it's an honor to have you visit us.
In your opinion, how much longer do you think the war will last?
I'd like to defeat the Fire Lord by the end of summer, but I can't do that without finding an earthbending teacher first.
Well, Master Yu is the finest teacher in the land. He's been teaching Toph since she was little.
Then she must be a great earthbender. Probably good enough to teach someone else.
Ow!
You're awfully cute, but unfortunately for you, you're made of meat. Just a bit closer. Ah! Ah!
Gotcha!
You are one lucky little meat creature.
All right, dessert for breakfast. These people sure know how to train an avatar. Mmm, Katara, you gotta try these.
Well, maybe just a bite.
Sokka, what's your problem? Eat.
Not hungry.
But you're always hungry.
He's just upset because a bunch of girls kicked his butt yesterday.
They snuck up on me.
Right. And then they kicked your butt.
Sneak attacks don't count. Tie me up with ropes, and I'll show them a thing or two. I'm not scared of any girls. Who do they think they are, anyway? This is tasty.
Whoever's in there might help me figure out this avatar thing.
And whoever's in there might have a medley of delicious cured meats.
Come on, Momo, that's fair. Appa's got 5 stomachs.
Prince Zuko, you must try this cake.
I don't have time to stuff my face. I must capture the Avatar to regain my honor.
Well, while you do that, maybe I'll capture another slice.
You sicken me. The Avatar's on Kyoshi Island?
Uncle, ready the rhinos. He's not getting away from me this time.
Are you going to finish that?
I was going to save it for later.
Throw them. A feast.
The people in my city have gotten fat from too many feasts, so I hope you like your chicken with no skin.
Thanks, but I don't eat meat.
How about you? I bet you like meat.
Is it just me, or is this guy's crown a little crooked?
So tell me, young bald one, where are you from?
I'm from Kangaroo Island.
Oh, Kangaroo Island, eh? I hear that place is really hopping.
You two must not be from around here. We know better than to touch the white jade, much less make it into tea and drink it.
Oops!
So where are you traveling from?
Yes, we're travelers.
Do you have names?
Names? Of course we have names. I'm Lee, and this is my uncle, Mushi.
Yes, my nephew was named after his father, so we just call him Junior.
Mushi and Junior, huh? My name is Song. You two look like you could use a good meal. Why don't you stay for dinner?
Sorry, but we need to be moving on.
That's too bad. My mom always makes too much roast duck.
Where do you live exactly?
Look at that, though. Is that a little hairy fella riding that thing?
No, that's what they call a limu. Saw one at a traveling show once. Real smart, they say.
Bet he tastes a lot like possum chicken.
You think everything tastes like possum chicken.
Come on now, fellas. Just a little closer. Nice and easy. Nothing to worry about. We just fixing to eat ya.
What'd you say that for?
Well, we are.
But you don't have to tell them that.
Well, how'd I know they'd understand me?
Come on!
Your questions will be answered when you're old enough to enter the Air Temple Sanctuary. Inside, you will meet someone who will guide you on your journey.
Who is it?
When you are ready, he will reveal himself to you.
Now, are you going to help me with these cakes or not?
All right.
One, two, three.
You probably think I deserve this, don't you? Look, I'm sorry I hunted you, but that's just the natural order of things. Big things eat smaller things, nothing personal. But this time it didn't work out that way. I admit it. You're cute. Okay, you convinced me. If I get out of this alive, it's a karmically correct vegetarian existence for me. No meat. Even though meat is so tasty. Hey, looks like my karma's already paying off. That's okay, I got it. Yeah.
Now come back, Boomerang.
Would you care for some bread, Katara?
So it was you guys who had food.
Oh, come now. You really think that tribe of thieves isn't smuggling food? Why should my people go hungry when the sneaky Zhangs are stuffing their faces?
Well, I guess it's okay if everyone's doing it.
Care for some meat?
Would I?
I know what you must be thinking. We're horrible for endangering everybody by bringing food down here. The Ganjin think so badly of us, they probably assumed we brought food in and decided to bring food in themselves. That's why we brought food in. Our conflict with the Ganjin goes back over 100 years.
That's just terrible. You're gonna finish that? I can't believe we're here in the House of Nonsense.
Try to keep an open mind, Sokka. There are things in this world that just can't be explained. Wouldn't it be nice to have some insight into your future?
It would be nice to have some bean curd puffs.
Is that the big ear guy who Aunt Wu predicted you'd marry?
Enjoy your snack.
Welcome, young travelers. Now, who's next? Don't be shy.
I guess that's me.
Not bad, not bad.
I'm good on puffs.
Puff is still learning the basics.
Yes, and sadly, because of her blindness, I don't think she will ever become a true master.
Oh, I'm sure she's better than you think she is.
What's your problem?
What's your problem?
Well, shall we move to the living room for dessert, then?
You're Guru Patik, right? The person who attached the note to Appa's horn?
Indeed. I was a spiritual brother of your people and a personal friend of Monk Gyatso.
In your note, you said you could teach me to gain control of the Avatar state. How?
You must gain balance within yourself before you can bring balance to the world. And the first step to gaining balance begins with this. Drink up.
Ugh, it tastes like onion and banana juice.
That's because it is. Yum, yum.
Over here.
Little help.
Genomite is made of rock candy. Delicious.
So far, this intermission is the best part of the play.
Apparently, the playwright thinks I'm an idiot who tells bad jokes about meat all the time.
Yeah, you tell bad jokes about plenty of other topics.
I know!
To the death, and let this be the end of this rivalry.
You know, I take it back. Harsh words aren't so bad. Is that food? Everyone smuggled food down here? Unbelievable! You guys put our lives in danger because you couldn't go without a snack for a day? You are all awful! So hungry.
Is that egg custard in that tart?
Okay, karma person or thing, whoever's in charge of this stuff. If I can just get out of this situation alive, I will give up meat and sarcasm. Okay? Ow! That's all I got. It's pretty much my whole identity. Sokka, the meat and sarcasm guy. But I'm willing to be Sokka, the veggies and straight talk fellow. Deal? Aang! Thank goodness! Have you got any meat?